everyone, and welcome back to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect, where we connect you to wildlife species, conservation careers, and new technologies that are used to study all types of species. My name is Chelsea McKinney, your host, and today we're going to take a distance learning adventure all the way to the west coast of the United States in Ventura, California at Hopper Mountain National Wildlife Refuge, where U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service employees are working very hard to protect the California condor. The California condor is the largest flying bird in North America. With a 10-foot wingspan, they can soar as high as 15,000 feet. That's about half the size of Mount Everest. These guys feed on large carrion, which is dead carcasses or animals, such as cattle and deer. And once they eat, they can go several days before even needing to eat again. But the truly incredible part is that just 25 years ago, there were only about 22 California condors in the entire world. They were on the verge of extinction and are truly the comeback story. Today we have wildlife biologist Joseph Brant here with us to tell us the story. Joseph, thank you so much for being with us
today.
Thanks,
Chelsea. I'm really happy to be here.
Can you tell us some fun facts about the condor?
Well, you know, as you mentioned, condors are a great, great big bird. They're the biggest in North America, and that 10-foot wingspan is the width of a school bus. And they take those wings, those great big wings, and use them to soar great distances. For example, in a single day, they can fly the distance between New York City and Washington, D.C. So they go places. And that entire time, they don't flap their wings at all. They use the air currents to soar, and that's how they get around.
Can you tell us about your job as a wildlife biologist and working with condors and how you got into this incredible career?
Yeah, so I have a really great job with the Fish and Wildlife Service. I love it a lot. My job is essentially to track and monitor the population of California condors in the Southern California region. So I lead a team of biologists that essentially chase condors around for a living, which is pretty exciting. It takes us into really, really awesome country, really remote canyon country, into the mountains. But really, we're tracking the condors because they're endangered, and we're trying to find out what's causing them to be endangered. So we follow the condors around to see what they're feeding on, to see how they're nesting, and that lets us know if they're healthy, if the environment is healthy for them or not.
And what is the reason the California condors become endangered?
Well, California condors are endangered in part because they're dying from lead poisoning. So they ingest carrion. So condors feed on just big dead things, and if that carrion's been shot with lead ammunition, which is typically what bullets are made out of, that carrion becomes contaminated with lead, and the condors will eat that contaminated food and become very sick, just like children. If you're playing with a toy that has lead paint, you'll get sick from the lead if you put it in your mouth. And condors kind of suffer that same sort of issue with lead in their food.
Joseph, what kinds of technologies are being used to track and observe condors?
Well, Chelsea, because condors fly such great distances, we have to use some pretty special technology to track them around. So one device I have here in my pocket is called a radio transmitter. And so this little guy, we attach to a condor's feather, and what that does is it gives us a radio signal that allows us to track the condor with this fancy piece of equipment right here.
Wow.
So this is a receiver and a Yagi. And the Yagi is a special antenna that allows me to point, where I point this, it will start beeping if I'm pointing it in the direction of that transmitter. So I've got a transmitter up here, up the way. So let me just kick this thing on a little bit. So that's the sound of what this is what a condor would sound like if there was a condor up the way with one of these receivers. If we were tracking one, exactly. So, you know, I'm pointing it in this direction, and I can hear the condor, and I know it's in that direction because when I move this antenna away, it starts to get quiet.
Now, I know there were 22 condors in existence back in the 1980s. What are the populations doing right now?
Well, so the populations are growing now, but that's in part because of all the hard work that we're doing trying to recover the species. There are over 400 condors. There's about 430 condors in the world, and over half of those condors are out in the wild.
Joseph, why are condors so important to the ecosystem?
So condors and their relatives, like the turkey vulture and the black vulture, which are found in other parts of the United States, are a part of nature's cleanup crew. So they fly around searching for all the dead things that are out there and gobble them up.
Is there anything else that students can do to learn about the California condor?
Sure. So the California condor is an endangered species, which is protected by a law called the Endangered Species Act. So learning about that act, that law, is a great way to kind of understand how condors are being protected. They can also, you know, train and become observers themselves by learning to become a wildlife biologist like myself. And to help them do that, we actually have a webcam that's on a Facebook page where we're posting clips. It's called the Condor Cave.
Perfect. Joseph, thank you so much for being with us today and giving us all this wonderful information about the California condor.
Yeah, thank you, Chelsea. It was a real pleasure.
Remember, you guys can check out that webcam at the URL link on your screen below. You can learn about what biologists do and become wildlife educators at your own schools to help protect these extraordinary creatures. Thank you all so much for joining us today. We'll see you guys next time on the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect.